Hi and welcome to this edition of Out the Box. My name is Paul. Today we're going to have a look at what is in this box. This is the brand new Ubiquiti Dream Machine Special Edition. So the UDM, well, there's two definitions for it, the UDM-SE, or probably more exactly the UDM-Pro-SE. So not going to be a big technical overview, but I do want to show you what's in the box and talk about some of the specification changes. So this is the device itself, which we'll have a look at in a moment. You are going to get a get started guide there with its little QR code. You're going to get the rack ears for mounting that in the rack. It is a rack mountable appliance. You are going to get a carton containing the bolts and brackets to be able to mount that in the rack. Alternatively, feet if you want to be able to mount that on a shelf. And you're going to get the power cable. We're going to swap these out. These are for you in Australia, but these come at the moment where we get these from with a standard European plug. We do include that in the package because they have a new locking Iec connector on the end, which we started to see on all the enterprise range of Ubiquiti. It's got a little clip in the side. Not sure if you can see that, but I'll show you how that works in a moment. Many of the different countries in the world haven't had these specialized cables made yet, so we leave them in the box for you to do as you desire to do with them. So let's have a look at the unit itself. Now, if you're used to the UDM already, all right, then this is exactly the same look. So let me just hold that up so you can actually see it. One of the main things that we have on a UDM Pro, it is the Pro model, so we can see that we have got these small slits across the top. And actually these are mirrored on the back here. This is to allow airflow to come from the front to the back. As you can see here, there are no side vents. So this will fit in a hot or cold aisle containment system if you have that. So let's just walk through the things that you have on the front. Let me see if I can show you. So over here we have our two 10 gig SFP plus ports. One's generally designated as the WAN and another one is potentially your LAN or another port. We're followed over here by another WAN port. This is your primary WAN port. It's got an RJ45 connector on it, but it supports 1 gig and 2.5 gigabits a second. Then over here we have a small 8-port switch. This is the thing that's probably more exciting for everybody. Everybody said when they released the UDM Pro, why did it not do PoE? So now we have a small 8-port useful switch, all right? The last 6 ports on here are PoE plus AF, which means that they support about 15 watts per port. And the first two, port 1 and 2, are AT, which support 30 watt a port. So essentially we've got 150 watts of power across all of these ports. Let me just hold that up so you can just again have a little bit of a better look. Then we move here to our hard drive bay. Let me just open that up for you and take the tray out so I can show you. You can fit both a 3.5 and a 2.5 inch drive in there if you want to. We have customers running at the moment up to at least 14 terabytes and beyond in these. They were originally rated to only be up to 8 terabytes, but should successfully work with larger hard drives now as well. And then moving on to this side here, we have our small little LCD screen, touch screen that you would have got used to now in most of the enterprise models, where it can show you some of the configuration settings and you can make a few changes on there or reboot the box itself. So that's the front of the unit. As I said before, no side cooling. We draw that over the top. Now at the back, all right, over here we have our RPS connector, which is the redundant power supply. Again, to remind you, this is not an uninterruptible power supply. This is the redundant power supply system that Ubiquiti have, is the idea that you'd have one device connected to one main source, and one device connected to another through their RPS module. And it means if the first power source was to fail, it will switch over to this. It's going to give you continuity if one of your feeds fails, but it's not about losing power to your building altogether. All right, now then over here, you have the power socket for your mains lead. So let me just take that out. I'm going to hopefully just hold that up a little bit closer. You can see here it's got a little switch on there. So what we've seen on most of the enterprise models now is the IEC connector, when it clicks into place, let me show you how it's into place. We can use this switch to lock it into place, if I can hold the cable there for you. And if we give it a good pull, that cable now won't come out. So it's quite a nice little feature. You know, once you've mounted that into the rack, it's not going to be coming out as you bring it out if you need to change it for maintenance. But hopefully that's been useful. I'll just hold that up so you can see the front again. And the back. So the main differences that we see in here is this has 128 gig SSD built into it, ready to go. And like we said, we have 8 ports of PoE. Do head on over to our YouTube channel. We've got plenty more box openings on wireless firewalls and networking devices. We've got how-to guides. What do I need to do to get Unify Protect up and running, which can be run from this? What do I need to do to create my Unify network, which again can be run on this? If you're looking to run all of those different Ubiquiti products, this is the unit for you. But do check out our YouTube channel, stay up to date, and hopefully that's been useful. That's the Dream Machine Special Edition.